CODA show, we can be able to do that.
Sir, is it safe sabihin natin hindi tayo nawala ng territory or parte ng Pilipinas sa pag-alis po ng Teresa Magbanua?
It is not just safe for us to say it, but it is wrong to say na may inabandon or iniwan or nawalan tayo ng teritoryo sa Escoda Show. Paulit-ulit kong sasabihin, we have not lost anything. We did not abandon anything. Escoda Show is still part of our exclusive economic zone. We can deploy vessels anytime we like. We can go there anytime we like. It won't be difficult for us because there are different approaches for the Coast Guard vessels to enter Escoda Show.
Hello.
137 square kilometers.
Sir, morning. One of the reasons why we, deployed, at least sa mga narrative ng Coast Guard, was we deployed to Escoda to specifically prevent yung reclamation and occupation and presence of the Chinese Coast Guard and militias there. With the retreat, so to speak, or redeployment back to base ng of
ayaw sa'yo, Sir Chino.
With the redeployment of the BRP Teresa Magbanua, with an eye to the mission
that he will
that the Teresa Magbanua is there to safeguard and prevent the regulations, yung return niya ba, yung forced return niya, isa gifting para sa kamisara for the Coast Guard? Would you consider that? Kasi some people are saying.
No. It's not a defeat. As I said, related to my response a while ago, it's not also the Coast Guard abandoning our post in Escoda Shoal. We are just repositioning our own vessels. The only reason why we directed Magbanua is to address the concerns that I mentioned. But it doesn't mean that the Coast Guard vessels will no longer be deployed there. Again, these are just operational details, but you have the commitment of the Commandant of the Philippine Coast Guard. We have other Coast Guard vessels that, as we speak right now, may have been or may already been proceeding to Escoda Shoal. But again, these are operational details.
But we can guarantee na wala circulation na mangyayari dahil wala tayo.
Alam mo, Sir Chino, reclamation of the Chinese maritime features took them almost 4 years. From 2013 to 2017, this is how long they reclaimed Mischief Reef, Gavin Reef, Quarter Run, and other areas. No? Hindi naman siguro mali-reclaim yan kung in just a matter of hours nawala tayo. Well, Sir Chino, kaya nga sinasabi natin, no? Ang Teresa Magbanua, let us not discount the fact that they were successful in their mission for 5 months. The mere fact that the Coast Guard was able to prevent the reclamation from happening from April until the last day she left there. Ibig sabihin, the Coast Guard can carry out whatever it takes for us to make sure that China will not be able to occupy and even reclaim Escoda Shoal.
The situation on Escoda Shoal is getting harder. So what support can your security partners, the US and Japan, offer? What support do you need?
Well, these are questions that is better addressed to the Department of Foreign Affairs or the Department of National Defense. But let me take this opportunity to thank the Embassy of Japan, again, for the filters of our desalinator. We also have requested for the spare of those desalinators. As you are aware, the Coast Guard vessels that we have, the 9701 and the and the 44-meter vessels are all constructed by the Japanese shipyards. So those kind of support can also be needed by the Philippine government, by the Philippine Coast Guard.
Hi, sir. Mark from the street. Hello, Yan. Sir, I know operational details you can't really give, but bakit hindi tayo bago palabasin, bago tanggalin po for now yung BRP Teresa Magbanwa? And hindi po ba risk yon na we left it nga to the Chinese? Hindi po ba mahihirapan tayo bumalik? I understand it's so much bigger, but they have so much more ships. And we've seen a more aggressive China these past couple of months. Wala po ba tayong concern? Baka sir, baka yung can-explain, ba't hindi tayo nakapagpalit?
Alam mo, Mara, meron kaming concern. Hindi kami sa wala concern. No? But again, uulitin-ulit, no? The bad weather condition has compelled us to deploy, to, you know, recall our vessel in Skoda Show. Kung ang intention lang natin is to retrieve itong Teresa Magbanwa, the question is, kung meron din ba tayong capability na maglaot from Palawan going to Skoda? Kung pangit nga ang panahon dahil nga i-recall natin. I mean, logically speaking, it's very difficult for us to explain, but that's the only way we can, you know, explain this kind of things.
One last question for me, sir. Sir, are you seeing China doing more blockades within the West Philippine Sea? And what can the Philippine Coast Guard do given that, you know, they're more superior in terms of equipment, in terms of the number of vessels they are able to deploy, not just Coast Guard, but also, you know, their maritime condition?
Well, let me first correct you, no? Let us not use blockade because blockade has a different connotation. The Chinese government, the only thing that they're doing is to harass and to unlawfully carry out dangerous maneuver in the entire West Philippines. I don't think that blockade is the right terminology to describe this kind of illegal and barbaric activities of the Chinese maritime forces. This kind of actions have always been considered. We are always calibrating our approach and deployment of the vessels in the entire West Philippine Sea. And I think it's not also accurate to say that the Chinese maritime forces have been very effective in harassing our deployment in different areas of the West Philippine Sea. It is only pretty much targeted. Like, that's what they do in Bajo de Masinloc, also in Ayungin, also in Skoda. But the entire West Philippine Sea, it's a very big body of water. So I just want to make this an opportunity to explain that once you write something in talking about the West Philippine Sea, clearly define it like it's a targeted harassment, not harassment in the entire West Philippine Sea, because it has different connotation.
Good morning.
There's information that a 44-meter ship has been deployed or will be deployed to replace the
Well, una sa lahat, no? For the desalinators. Ang desalinators ay ipina-DHL na nila. Tama ba, Tornin? That's how fast the Japanese, the Embassy of Japan help us for the filters. So hopefully within this week, those filters will be arriving na sa kinuha pa nga nila ang address ng headquarters kasi door-to-door talaga to eh, ng DHL, no? We are expecting 4 sets of desalinators. So, dalawa para sa 9701 and dalawa para sa 9702. So I hope I already answered your question. For the for your first question about the 44 meter vessel, of course the 44 meter vessel, it has longer duration of patrol, somewhere between probably 7 to 10 days, a week for additional 3 days. But it doesn't mean na pag dumating ulit doon, aalis na naman. We can be able to, you know, strategize like 144 and then replacement in place, another 44 meter or 97 meter for much longer, those kind of things. But again, these are operational details that I don't want to explain further, but at least for you to have an understanding that it doesn't follow that we have smaller vessel and we're a bit, you know, not considerate about the number of days we can stay in Skoda.
Hi, sir. Good morning. Bea Cupin from Rappler. Sir, there have been, as mentioned earlier, inevitable comparisons to the Bajo de Masinloc standoff in 2012. I understand you've already explained the difference, but I think one stark difference here is that leading up to the Magbanua's return to port, it was months, weeks of really intense harassment, brute force from Chinese maritime forces. What does the PCG and the MTF perhaps also think of these comparisons, again, to the 2012 standoff in Bajo de Masinloc? And what does this say, you think, yung changes between a decade about China's actions or the shift in China's actions in the West Philippine Sea?
I think that's better addressed by the National Maritime Council. Ayoko mag... Kasi pag nagsalita ako, baka sabihin. Again, let us stop comparing Bajo de Masinloc with that of Skoda Show. Napakalaki ng pinagkaiba niya, no? Bajo de Masinloc, ulitin ko ulit, isang entry point lang. Kaya nga, every time na magpapatulya ang Coast Guard, BFAR, alam nyo rin yan, you've been embedded whenever we go to Bajo de Masinloc. Yung nag-iisang entry point na yon na hindi na inalisan ng Chinese Coast Guard sa loob, ay nilalagyan pa nila ng harang to make sure na nobody gets in inside the lagoon of Bajo de Masinloc. Skoda Shoal is entirely different. Ang dami niyang pwedeng pasukan. Ang lagoon niya hindi lang din nag-iisa. Alam ko, nakapunta na rin kayo ng Sabina. Meron siyang West Lagoon, East Lagoon, at for each lagoon, there are more than 5 entry points na pwede mong pasukan. So I don't think that there is a similarity between Bajo de Masinloc and Skoda Shoal. Regarding the change, I think the NMC can respond to that.
Okay, good morning, sir. I'm going to belabor you again on that part.
Na-miss ko na to si Barnaby. Ngayon lang kita uli nakita.
Talaga? Ah, okay, sige. I'll go with, sorry, but I have to belabor you again.
You always.
On that point, yes. wouldn't it be fair to say that the Philippine Coast Guard or the Teresa Magbanua was forced to retreat, or because of the strategy of the Chinese to starve the crew of the Teresa Magbanua? You know, as we all saw, the crew members came back to port dehydrated and ill. And if that is so, then they would just keep doing that. And they could also do that because, you know, for us who have been to the Second Thomas Shoal or Ayungi Shoal, Sabina Shoal is on the way to Ayungi Shoal. So would it also affect the resupplies to the BRP Sierra Madre?
I think forced by the Chinese to for us to go back, I don't think so. Hindi naman ako naniniwala mas malakas sila kay Lord para magpabagyo ng Palawan. Diba? Again, it's not just the supplies that compelled us to go back to the port in Puerto Princesa. It's the bad weather condition. Supposing that it's a fair weather, it would be very easy for us, just like what Ma'am Mape said, to do airdrop or other ways, right? Because we have done it last August 28. There are other possible ways for us to sustain our stay in Skuadashore. But the bad weather condition is really the primary factor that made the commandant decide to bring Teresa Magbanua.
But with dozens of Chinese ships there, are they able to establish a more permanent presence than the Philippine government?
No. I would argue that permanent presence is not something that the Chinese maritime forces have already done in Skuadashore. As I said, when Teresa Magbanua departed Skuadashore, the Chinese forces are also subjected to that bad weather condition. It's not just 9701 who left Skuadashore. We can document that even the Chinese have also left because of that very bad weather condition.
And there's dozens of Chinese ships there. You know, you mentioned that the area is much larger than the Scarborough Shoal. So despite the presence of dozens of Chinese ships there, those dozens of Chinese ships, maritime militia, Coast Guard, Chinese Navy, they're not going to be enough, in your opinion, to
yes.
block the Philippine Coast Guard from entering the shoal.
Yesterday, the only number of vessels that were there is down to 11. 11 Chinese maritime militia. There were no Chinese Coast Guard vessels. There were no hospital ship. No PLA Navy tugboats. As of yesterday.
Hi, sir. Good morning. Maricar po. Sir, clarification lang, sir. Yung recall of the Teresa Magbanua, it was a call made by Admiral Gavan. And kailan siya, sir, nag-decide to recall the ship?
Again, the very bad weather condition for so many times. No? Ang pangit na panahon ang talagang nag-compel kay Commandant to recall Teresa Magbanua. And of course, the dwindling supplies and those personnel who needs medical care.
But sir, wala sa plano, supposedly, dapat mag-extend pa sana si Magbanua, sir? For...
Yes. As I said, even the commanding officer no, has to apologize when he reported for his mission accomplishment in Puerto Princesa. He was teary-eyed and then he said, I'm sorry, sir, I have to bring back the vessel. It's because it was never really our plan during that time for Teresa Magbanua to go back to the port.
Thank you, sir. Sir, last na lang. Sir, if I remember correctly, sir, during the ramming or collision ng Teresa Magbanua, there was mentioned na parang you are or the NDF is considering na i-extend yung provisional agreement from, currently Ayungin to cover Escoda. Can you tell us, may ganun ba, sir? Is there, are there talks going on about and then where are we?
I think that kind of question is better addressed by the Department of Foreign Affairs and the National Maritime Council. Just for the record, it's not the idea of the National Task Force West Philippines. I think somebody else said it.
Sir, follow-up question. Are we not considering at this point to perhaps, one, send Philippine Navy ships as well to the shoal to, you know, augment the PCG's vessels? Kasi we know that several vessels have been damaged rather substantially during missions to Skuadashore.
Bea, as a Coast Guard officer, I can only talk about the deployment of Coast Guard vessels.
Moving beyond the Philippines, sir, are we not considering at this point to ask the help of our partners, our allies, in entering Escoda again? Future patrols, perhaps in the West Philippine Sea, is that not yet a consideration at this point?
The response to that question is beyond my pay grade. It's for the DFA and the DND to discuss.
Sir, just to follow up on what you said, that it wasn't the WPSTF who's proposed to for the extension of the provisional agreement in Ayungin. Why do you not think that it was wise for the to extend the provisional agreement to cover Escoda? What was the, you know, the argument against it? What, why isn't it beneficial to the Philippines?
I don't, I have my personal response to that question, but again,
personal response as well.
I won't comment on that. And again, it, for the record, it's not the National Task Force who said that. It's somebody else.
Yes, but what does the, you know, what does the task force feel that would be the better course? If it's not to extend the provisional agreement, what else can we do to, you know, to make it easier for our forces to resupply whichever ship is already deployed?
I'm only authorized to discuss operational details as to that kind of diplomatic and policy issues. It's for the DFA and the National Maritime Council to respond to.
Sir, very quick follow-up lang. Sir, magpapadala pa rin tayo ng ship, di ba sir, sa Escoda Shoal, pero hindi pa natin madidisclose. But sabi po, mission accomplished na si BRP Teresa Magbanua. And kung magpapadala pa po tayo doon, does it mean na mayroon pa siyang kailangang bantayan doon sa Escoda Shoal? And gaano pa po katagal do you think itong mission na to would entail?
Well, the deployment of Coast Guard vessels is not just purely focused in Escoda Shoal. Of course, as you are aware, we pass through different maritime features that we occupy. But it doesn't mean that we're just going to purely concentrate in Escoda Shoal.
We'll entertain last question.
Kayo na last.
Hi, Sir Mads from Net25. Sir, yung decision ba to recall Magbanua is sole decision of Admiral Gavan? Hindi niya ba kinonsulto sa Malacanang or someone higher than him?
Well, of course, it was consulted. Those people who have, who needs to give the green light for Admiral Gavan, they were consulted. As to the specific people, I don't want to disclose. Tapos si Barnaby.
Sir, parang ang malinaw lang dito.
Could you also say this? Parang, we did the surrender scholarship.
Parang ito yung message ngayon ng press ko na to, sir. We did not surrender. The Philippines did not surrender po.
Yes, we did not surrender. Lagi ko nga sinasabi, wala naman tayong isinurrender. Wala tayong isinuko. The mere fact na pinull out lang natin ang Teresa Magbanua, it is wrong to say na isinuko na natin. And it's also wrong to say na kapag nawala tayo doon, magre-reclaim. Again, the reclamation would take 4 years. Kung mawala ba tayo ng isang araw, dalawang araw, tatlong araw, isang linggo, makagawa na sila ng runway, right? It doesn't go that way. Second, pag sinabi ba nating nag-pull out tayo, hindi na tayo makakabalik. Paulit-ulit ko nga sinasabi, napakalaki ng Escoda Shoal. Hindi siya katulad ng Bajo de Masinloc na isa lang ang papasukan. Marami siyang papasukan. So, it's a misconception na sinuko natin, hindi na tayo makakabalik. Definitely, wala tayong isinuko, wala tayong inalisan, dahil pwede natin itong balikan in different ways. Second, again, the Commandant of the Philippine Coast Guard, sinabi niya na rin to. And even the NMC spokesperson has already disclosed na meron tayong deployment ng Coast Guard vessels. It doesn't end na sinabing ang Teresa Magbanua, binunot na, ibig sabihin isinuko na. Kasi paulit-ulit namin sasabihin, ang Escoda Shoal ay patuloy nating titindigan, patuloy nating pagpapatulyahan, and our deployment in Escoda Shoal doesn't end dahil pinaalis natin si Teresa Magbanua.
The series of clashes in August and now with the back to port. Would you now conclude that the hotline that was established between the foreign ministries of China and the Philippines isn't working?
Well, I'm not sure about the hotline of the Department of Foreign Affairs and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, whether it's working or whether they're using it. I think that question is better addressed to the Department of Foreign Affairs. Thank you very much.
Thank you.